In this video, we are going to see the behavior of aggregate supply, right? Now, to see the behavior of aggregate supply, we must know how we can find out aggregate supply. Aggregate supply is equal to C plus S. As aggregate demand is equal to C plus I, same way aggregate supply is equal to C plus S. Consumption plus savings is equal to aggregate supply. Now, we have created one schedule. Right, this is the same schedule as we have created for aggregate demand. Now, using the same schedule only, we will get to know how we can find out aggregate supply. Right, so we are having level of employment starts from 0, then 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, and 60. Right, why income level? Income level when no one is working, employment level is 0. Same way, income level is also 0. Then, as level of employment is increasing, what is happening? The level of income is increasing every time by 50. Then consumption, right? When income is 0, still consumption is 50. Then after that, consumption is also increasing 25 at all levels of income. Then we can find out savings, right? Savings we can find out by applying the formula Y minus C. S is equal to Y minus C. So 0 minus 50 is equal to minus 50, 50 minus 75 is equal to minus 25, 100 minus 100, break even point, savings will be 0. Then savings are increasing. Every time savings are also increasing by 25, 25, right? So now we will get to know aggregate supply. Aggregate supply is equal to C plus S, consumption plus savings. So 50 minus 50, 0, 75 minus 25, 50, 100 plus 0 is equal to 100, 125 plus 25, 150, 150 plus 50, 200, 175 plus 75, 250, 200 plus 100 is equal to 300. Now, one thing you can see here that all the values of aggregate supply are same as income level. Here it is 0, it is 0, this is 50, 100 and 100, 150 and 150. So, in other words, we can say that aggregate supply is equal to income level, right? Aggregate supply is equal to income level. So simply, if they will tell you that you have to find out aggregate supply by income method, right? So aggregate supply means national income only. So here you will get to know, if CBSE will twist the question that you have to find out aggregate supply by income method, then this means you have to find out national income, right? So this is same. Now we will draw the curve for the same also. On x-axis we have taken income, and income will always remain on x-axis only, and on y-axis we have taken aggregate supply. So the values are 0, 50, 100, 150, 200. Same way the values of aggregate supply are also 0, 50, 100, 150 and 200. Now when income is 0, aggregate supply is also 0, right? So here point will come. This side it is 50, aggregate supply is also 50. Income is 100, aggregate supply is also 100. Income is 150, aggregate supply is 150. Income is 200 and aggregate supply is also 200. So all the points are same, right? So after joining all these points, we will get this curve. We will get this straight line curve, which is starting from the origin, right? Which is showing income will be 0, aggregate supply will be 0. And we will get this upward sloping straight line curve, right? This is known as aggregate supply curve. And aggregate supply curve is also income curve also, right? So this is one and the same thing. This is income line also. As I told you, in different diagrams, consumption function, I have drawn this line, right? So that line has come from here. Aggregate supply and income is one and the same thing. Now, this line is in the center. This line is dividing this axis. Now, this axis is of 90 degree, right? So this line, aggregate supply, is dividing the axis into two equal parts. So this line is the line of 45 degree line, right? Why it is 45 degree? Because at each and every point on aggregate supply curve, income and aggregate supply both are equal to each other. So keep in mind, income or aggregate supply line will be 45 degree line. When you will draw it, you have to make it sure that it is 45 degree only. Otherwise, the examiner can make it wrong also, right? So this should be 45 degree. Thank you.